Heavy rainfall and severe thunderstorms impacting parts of eastern Australia today, with persistent heavy falls for southeastern New South Wales and parts of eastern Victoria, as well as the ongoing thunderstorm outbreak affecting the eastern states. We'll start by looking at the radar imagery from this morning. Note this area of yellow and red. That's the heavier rainfall, which has brought over 200 millimetres in 24 hours to parts of New South Wales, with another 100 on the way. That has already caused flash and surface flooding in that area. Also note how everything moving southwards, and there's even a bit of rotation to the movement of the rain. That's because it's all wrapping around a low pressure centre, which is up here over central parts of New South Wales, and this low is moving to the south-southeast, and that means the rain is moving south-southeast, and that's why we've seen a shift in our warnings compared to yesterday. These are the current severe weather warnings: further heavy rain and damaging winds around the south coast district of New South Wales, as well as a number of regions in the south and southeast of Victoria, where the heavy rain and the strong winds anticipated to build through the day today and continue into the day tomorrow. With all of this incoming rainfall across Victoria and New South Wales, there will be a response from the river network. These are flood watches covering almost all eastern rivers in Victoria and southeastern parts of New South Wales too. Of particular note, keep an eye on this one here. That's a little red area showing the possibility of major flooding around the Bega River in the next day or two. As we zoom out, we'll see some further flood warnings in place across Queensland and northern New South Wales. In particular, major flood warning here for the Moonee River in Queensland. This is being driven by the ongoing thunderstorm outbreak across eastern and northern Australia. And let's show a new chart here. This is the thunderstorm outlook. There's a lot going on this map, so let's break it down. The green contour showing where thunderstorms are possible today. The pale green contour is where thunderstorms are likely today, but it's the yellow and the red areas we're more concerned with, showing the risk of severe thunderstorms through the course of the day today. In particular, this red area, severe thunderstorms likely, and when severe storms do form, they can bring heavy to intense rainfall, damaging to destructive wind, and large or even giant-sized hail. So a lot of severe weather possible around eastern parts of the country today. And even though we're in the yellow area, the risk of severe thunderstorms stretches all the way down the coast. Gold Coast, Brisbane, Newcastle, Sydney, Wollongong all have a chance of storms and severe storms later on in the day today. How much rain might these storms bring on top of what has already been pretty wet over the past couple of weeks? Well, we're expecting some further rainfall totals. This is two-day rainfall for Wednesday and Thursday together on the map. Now that you'll see the top values in those thunderstorm areas here and through the centre aren't particularly high, maybe 50 to 70 millimetres. But with severe thunderstorms, the problem is it all comes at once and it overwhelms the drainage. The more significant total accumulations over the next couple of days are down in the southeastern corner of the country. 200 millimetres of rain, not out of the question, giving us 300 millimetres or more over the course of this entire severe weather event. The majority of the rain and the storms are subsiding by the end of the week, but there's a lot of severe weather to happen before that. So do stay up to date with the latest. Keep your friends and family in that part of the country informed as well. You can always find up-to-date warnings at the Bureau website. Do check out our app, and we'll have another update for you tomorrow.